Dear student, welcome to my class. It's me, Rakesh Kumar Jha. I welcome all of you at Unacademy platform. Let's crack UPSC CSC exam with us. It is India's largest learning platform, and for all these things, we have to have, you know, daily live classes there, structured courses there, live tests and quizzes there, unlimited essays as well. For all these things, what you have to do, you have to just download Unacademy learning app. It's me, Rakesh Kumar Jha. I am an MA in Political Science from Ramdas College, Delhi University. PG Diploma in Journalism, Delhi University. I have also done Mass Communication from KU. I have also participated in different talk shows as an expert, and you know, at Akashvani, I have also participated as a speaker in a number of national and international seminars, workshops, and also renowned motivational speaker. I have also received certificates and appreciations by the reputed organizations. I have successfully guided a large number of students, some of them IAS officers, police officers, and as well. I have successfully guided a lot of students. My Telegram link is Discourse Academy Rakesh Jha, and Academy profile link is Rakesh7Jha8443. My philosophy is that be your own light, Atma Deepah Bhav. We have more than top 100 educators, Polity, Governance, IR is there. Geography, Science and Technology, NCERT Summary, History, Optional Courses, Environment, Ecology, Art and Culture, Current Affairs that I will be taking, Indian Economy, Practice, Strategy Session, Answer Writing Courses as well. We do have UPSC CSC subscription for 1 month, 10 for 3, 6 and 12 months as well. Besides, you know, Plus course is there, Iconic course is there. If you apply RJ01, you will have 10% discount. And please apply this my reference code, that is RJ01, for having 10% discounts. We do have live classes, test series, unlimited practice, structure schedule, personal coach, daily mains, answer practice, study planner, personalized feedback. These are the things that you can avail. RJ01 is my code. Please have this code and have the 10% discounts. Okay. So now I am also saying that I am also taking PSIR as an optional paper, Political Science and International Relations. And we do have, you know, up 1 month, up to 36 months, there is a provisions you can take any subscription. I am also taking live classes of current affairs at an academy platform. Right now, I am going to discuss about, dear student, you know, the political theory and Indian politics. Political Theory and Thinkers Part 10, I am going to discuss about this, okay. Now, let's see that this is the UPSC syllabus that you have to understand, and all these things I have already discussed. Now, I am going to discuss about Political Theory and Indian Politics, you know, Political Theory and Thinkers as well, equality, social, political and economic relationship between equality and freedom, affirmative action. Now, I am going to discuss about all these things because, you know, that we have to understand that what is, you know, economy, what is, you know, the equality, what is social, political and economic equality, because as a political science student, dear student, have to understand a lot of concepts of the political theory. And if you really understand all these topics in a very perfect and rightful manner, then definitely other things will be very easily for you to understand. The beauty of political science is something like that. Not necessarily that you should have done your master's or UG degree from the political science. As far as UPSC is concerned, in the UPSC pattern, any student when from science background or engineering background or from any background who can take the political science or international relation as an optional paper. Why? Because of the nature of the paper, because you have to study a lot of topics even in the GS paper. That is also very important in a sense, because I can make you sure that if you understand all these things, then definitely it will help you. Besides, also I am telling that, okay, please you study all these topics in a nitty-gritty way. Please you understand all these topics in a such a perfect way that you can do all the questions in a very rightful and perfect manner. Okay, so now are you ready to do these things? Okay, let's start. The first of all, I am going to discuss about the equality. What is the equality? First of all, in our society, you might have understood that equality is there, but what equality as a political science student you can understand? The belief of equality is a major assumption of a self-governing society. Equality does not entail complete equality. Equality originates from equalis, equus and equalities task. These are the old French or Latin words that you have to also understand. These French Latin words mean even, level and equal. In general term, equality means full equality of treatment and reward for all. It is needed as natural equality. It is thought that all men are born natural and free. Nevertheless, despite a strong emotional appeal to the hearts of the people, the concepts of the natural and absolute equality of all cannot be fully acknowledged and realized. Men are neither equal in respect of their physical features nor in respect of their mental capabilities. Some are stronger, others are weaker, some are more intelligent and capable than others. This is what you have to understand. Right now I am discussing about the equality, and you have to also understand that what does equality means. The basic point is that, because in a society, when you look at that, in even in your family or in the society, you can find out a lot of varieties of people are there. Some men, some women are having different set of minds and different kind of stuff. All are not, as it is said, that all the fingers are not same. Even the God had created something like that. But the same thing is also happening in our society, that everything is not equal, that is for sure. And even in the natural, it is there. But one thing that is also very much important, that we have to also understand that what exactly does it mean. That because, you know, if someone is weaker, cannot he have the right? Yes, definitely he should have also the equal right. It is the duty of the person that if the equal things are there, unequal things are there, maybe it is possibility that, you know, different kinds of people are living in the society. Physically we all are not same, and mentally also we all are not same. But it is the duty of the state to provide the equal opportunity, and that you have to also understand that until and unless the state is not creating the environment of equal opportunity, then how it is possible to provide equality? How it is possible to establish the equality among the members of the society? Because equality can bring only through the equal provisions of the opportunity in the state, or it has been given by the state itself. No other is going to provide this thing. And definitely, because that is why it is also saying that it may be possibility that if suppose you know IAS or UPSC is a exam. If the UPSC exam form is filled up by some students, maybe they are from unequal backgrounds, maybe from, you know, like maybe from political science, economics, geography, engineering. But when they pass the exam, so they became, you know, IAS officer. Same thing is happening, that equality is something like that. But at the same time, if you know, other constraints are also there. So these are all things you have to discuss. Okay. Actually, equality, that all people must have equal opportunities for development. In fact, when we talk of equality of all person, we really mean general and fair equality and not absolute equality. The term equality used in political science differs from uniformity, identity and sameness. Some people of course want to use it to denote uniformity, but this does not convey the meaning when it is used by political scientists. Equality does not mean obliteration of the diversity. I have to say you that actually this equality does not mean having the equal opportunities and for the development. In fact, you know, the equality is also not mean the uniformity, the identity. And definitely political scientists are saying that it does not mean the obliteration of the diversity, or it is the sameness. In fact, when you talk of equality, all person, we really mean general and fair equality and not the absolute equality. Absolute equality and the general equality, there is a difference. Because absolute equality is not possible even in the communism society, communism state. It is not possible because, you know, it is very simple that if a person is doing hard labor, then definitely he will getting more and more perks, pay and perks. He will getting more position in the society. That is there, and that is also there just because of the motivation of the person. Otherwise, if everyone thinks like this, that okay, even if I can do something or not, I will get the same salary, I will get the same amount, I will get the same respect, then people will not struggle, people will not do the hard work. That's very simple. So that is the point. The political scientists are saying equality means that any person in the name of physical kinds of things or in the any kinds of background, he cannot be deprived of any opportunity. So the equal opportunity is there, and if the opportunities are being given to, whether it is men and women or differently able people, if they pass the exam or if they meet the standard and the protocols of the examination, then what would happen? Then definitely they would win and they would get that job, and definitely in this way equality can prevail in the society by providing the opportunities of different backgrounds people. So precisely you have to take care of all these things, because you have to note all these things. If equality you have to maintain in the society, it means very simple, the equality can be maintained, equality can be obtained or established, but by providing the way, by providing the equal opportunities, the people who are from different backgrounds, and they have to also prove themselves by acquiring, by receiving that degree or that something which is required, serve that thing. That is the political economy. That is the, political equality. Equality does not mean that you have to just distribute among all the people uniformly. No, it is not possible, not feasible. Okay? That the thing that we have to write, have to think all the time. Okay? Now, after this, what I have to say, let's see the first thing, theoretical review. Many theorists defined equality in their own way. According to D.D. Raphael, right to equality proper is a right of equal satisfaction of basic human needs, including the need to develop and use capacity which are specifically human. This is also very important. Lasky described that equality means that no man shall be so blessed in the society that he can overreach his neighbor to extend which constitute a denial of later citizenship. What Raphael says, that you have to also quote, because in the political sense, dear student, you have to be all the time very specific, and you have to quote thinkers and philosopher name, because these are very important. The right to equality proper is a right of equal satisfaction of human needs, including the need to develop and use capacities which are specifically human. Lasky also described that equality means that no man shall be so placed in the society that he can overreach his neighbor and to extend which means constitutes a denial of later citizenship. Parker opined that equality means equal rights for all the people and the abolition of all special rights and privileges. This is what you have to also understand. I think that if you understand all these integrity, if you feel all these very important points, then definitely you would understand the things. This is what you have to also understand in a proper way. Next, D. Saratori explained that equality has so many facets and so many implications that after we have examined all from all the angles, we are left with a feeling of not having really mastered it. Therefore, as a whole, equality does not mean absolute equality in all spheres and to every person. It does not aim at identity of the treatment as intellectual and physical capacity varies. It opposes inequality treatment. It means complete and absolute equality at the bottom most level, and then equal opportunity to develop one's inner potentiality. Contemporary notion of political authority was innovative by Thomas Hobbes. John Locke. These are the two thinkers, two English thinkers, you know, Thomas Hobbes and, you know, John Locke, two thinkers of the 17th century. These two intellectuals proclaimed natural equality of human beings. Hobbes and Locke imagined human beings in a state of nature and explained why they would enter into a social contract with each other for the mutual benefit. Out of this contract came government, which was, you know, established for the protection of the citizens and endowed with the powers to the end. On this account, government derived its authority from the consent of the governed, not the natural superiority of a ruling class. It is also very important to understand, because I feel that what John Locke, what Thomas Hobbes in the 17th century, these both thinkers were from England, and they had in the notion, they said something very remarkable, that, you know, all the intellectuals are, you know, these two intellectuals proclaim natural equality of the human beings. God created everyone equally, that is said by the these two thinkers, Thomas Hobbes and the Locke. Hobbes and Locke imagined that the human beings in a state of nature and explained why they would enter into a social contact. Because definitely you have to also understand that why the people had entered, it is a kind of assumption you can also think of, why these people had come into the, definitely because of the mutual benefit, that okay, if I agree something, then definitely others would also respect the same thing. Out of this contract came government, and because of this social contract, the government came into the existence, which was established for the protection of citizens and endowed with the powers and commensurate to the end. This is what, so basically Thomas Hobbes, Locke, John Locke, both of them have said that okay, because this is the man, this is when men came, and because of the, it is about the understanding among the people of the society, that both of them, all of them came together and had a social contact. What kind of social contact? Social contact for the understanding, social contact for, you know, having all sort of things. This is what you have to also understand. And that's why this government came in. That's why the state came into the existence. This is the kinds of argument that John Locke and Hobbes have made. This is what you have to understand. On this account, government derived its authority from the consent of the governed, not the natural superiority of a ruling class. This is what we have to also believe in, that oh, okay, if it is there, if something is there, that has to be also understood. So basic and primary things that we have to also understand, that how these things are there, how this is very important for your study point of view. Okay, now neither Hobbes nor Locke concluded that people ought to rule themselves once government was established. However, Hobbes argued that the people should submit to an autonomous with the absolute powers, while Locke believed they would implicitly accept constitutional kingdom, receive the right to rebel against unjust governments. Thus, each man insisted on natural equality, but stopped short of recommending political equality. It's also very important that okay, that if you have gone for the like, you know, neither Hobbes nor Locke concluded the people out to ruin themselves. The government was established. However, Hobbes argued that people should submit to an autonomous with absolute powers, with Locke believed they would implicitly accept the constitutional kingdom. So there is a neither Hobbes nor Locke, the people out to rule themselves, because it is the government who said, you know, give the power. It is the power which is given by the people to the government. This is what we have to. So thus each man insisted on natural equality, but stopped short of recommending political equality. This is what you have to also understand. And I hope that if you understand all these things, then your grasp of the political science will be very, very perfect. Okay. And characteristics of equality. What are the characteristics of the equality? Equality does not stand for the absolute equality. It accepts the presence of some natural dissimilarity. Equality also, you know, stands for the absence of all unnatural man-made inequalities, and especially privileged class in the society. Equality assumes the grant and the guarantee of equal rights, the freedoms to all the people. Equality, you know, infers the system of the equal and adequate opportunities for all the people in the society. Equality means, you know, equal satisfaction of the basic needs of the persons before the special needs and luxurious of the some persons may be met. Equality supports an equitable and fair distribution of the world, wealth and resources. These are the things that we have to. So, characteristics, what are the equalities? So, characteristics of the equalities is something like that. That suppose it accepts the presence of some natural dissimilarity. Equality also stands for the absence of all unnatural man-made inequalities and especially privileged classes in the society. Equality also assumes that the grant guarantee of equal rights and freedom to all the people. So these are the important things that you have to also understand, and I think that if it is understood in a perfect and rightful manner, you have to understand all these things in a very perfect and very rightful manner. Okay. Now, equality means equal satisfaction of the basic needs. Equality also accepts the principles of protective discrimination for helping the weaker sections of the society. In the Indian political system, right to equality has been given to all. Yet there stands incorporated provisions for granting a special protection facility and reservations to persons belonging to scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, other backward classes, minorities, women and children. This is what we have to also understand. I feel that if you understand all these things, then definitely it would have a better positions, should have a better understanding, and I hope that if you understand all these nitty-gritties of the equality, if you know all dimensions of equality, you will have a better understanding of the topics, and definitely it would be a great, great advance of the learning, of knowing all these things. Next, you know, equality has three basic elements. Friends, you have to know that what are the three basic elements. The first thing, the absence of a special privileged in the society. Presence of adequate and equal opportunities for the development of all equal satisfactions of the basic needs of all the things. So, this is the equality that we have to also understand, that the equality has three basic elements. Whether it is absence of a special privilege in the society, whether it is the presence of adequate and equal opportunity for the development for all equal satisfaction of the basic needs of all, that you have to also understand. So I can assure you that if you study all these things, it would have a better understanding of all the points. And I hope that if you understand all these things, then definitely equality you will know in a better understanding. You can write the questions related to the equality, and definitely you can feel these all points in a very perfect and rightful manner. Now the next is that types of equality. What are the types of equality? The first one is the natural equality. This is also very important. What is natural equality? You have to also understand that if you understand the types of equality, the first one is the natural equality. Though humans differ in respect of their physical features, very true, psychological traits and mental abilities and capacities, all humans are to be treated as equal humans. All are to be considered to avail all human rights and freedoms. It is also very important that the human Maybe because you know, as we know, that God has created every individual, human being in a separate standing mode. All are having different mental abilities, capacities, all humans are having different kinds of things, but ultimately equality must be there, the natural equality must be there, the basic fundamentals must be there. So this is what the natural equality means. So you have to understand all these natural equality. Next, you know, social equality. So what does it mean? The social equality is referred as the equal rights and opportunities for the development of all classes of people without any discrimination, such as civil rights, freedom of speech, property rights, and equal access to the social goods and services. However, it also includes concepts of health, equity, economic equality, and other social security. It also includes equal opportunities and obligations, and also it involves the whole of society. So social equality is very simple, that government can provide the opportunities of each sections, so that what it can be happen, so that you know the people would have from different background have the opportunity to flourish, develop themselves. It is the duty of the state to provide the equal opportunities for every section of the society, so that they can also develop themselves. And it is also the constitutional guarantees. The constitution also gives the guarantees to every citizen of this country to have the equal opportunities, be it political opportunities, or may it economic equality, may it social equality, to develop themselves according to their choices. It is the duty of the state to provide such kinds of ambience, such kind of environment to flourish themselves. If it is necessary or if it is indeed needed, then it is the duty of the government or the state to provide some basic reservations to that particular deprived society, vulnerable social section of the society, or the weaker section of the society, so that they can also compete, so that they can also uplift in the society for a better development, for a better lifestyle, for a better quality of dignified life. These are the things that the social equality means. So if you open up the debate, what does social equality means, then you have to understand all these points. You have to write down all these points. Until unless you are not writing these things, it means that you do not know much about the social equality. Social equality can bring out only prosperity to those people who are not up to that level. So it is the duty of the government to provide that ambience, that environment. Besides, also it is also the aspirations of the people, because if you look at the other aspects, that in a society, if one section is developed, another section is not developed, then what would happen? It will also lead to the rest. You could have also seen that in most of the countries, or in most of the parts of our countries, have totally some disturbed area. Why? Because of their demands. They do not meet even basic rights. What is the point? That definitely they are having a lot of problems, a lot of troubles. Ultimately, it is the duty of a state to provide such an opportunities to its people. Okay, so it is the social equality that we have to also and all the other social equality, and you know, economic equality, health equity, lot of things, social security. Right, okay, this is the social equality. Social equality requires the absence of legally enforced social class or caste boundaries, and the absence of discrimination motivated by an alienation part of a person's identity. For instance, sex, gender, race, age, sexual orientation, origin, caste or class, income or property, language, religion, convictions, opinions, health or disability must not result in the unsecurity treatment under the law. Should reduce. Very good, because you know, social equality something like that on the basis of any part, maybe you know the gender part, maybe religion part, maybe you know the regional part, maybe any part, there must not be any impartiality. If that is there, then it is the gross mistakes, it is the gross violation of social equality. This is what you have to also understand. So I feel that if you understand all these things, then definitely you could have knowing all these points in a better way. Now, specifically, social equality stands for absence of the special privilege for any class or caste or the religious group or an ethnic group, provision of discrimination against any one of the basis of the caste, color and creed, free access to the public places. This is what you have to also understand, that how it is possible. No social segregation, it is also very important that you have to know. Equality of opportunities for all the people. It, however, accepts the concepts of the protective discriminations in favor of all weaker sections of the society. Contemporary theme of social equality is to eliminate gender inequality, ensure equal status and opportunities to the women, and to ensure equal rights of male and female children to live and develop. These are the things that you have to also understand, and if you understand, then definitely you have a lot of understanding of this topic. So what I have to say you that, dear student, please try to understand all these things, and I hope that if you understand all these things, definitely you would have a better understanding. So what I am saying, that this specifically social equality, it means what? The absence of special privileges for the any class or caste, the religion group or any ethnic group, provision of discrimination against anyone on the basis of caste, color, creed, religion is also there. Free access to the public places for all the people. Equality should be also given for all people. However, accepts the concept of protective discrimination in favor of all weaker sections of the society. And contemporary theme of the social equality is to also eliminate gender inequality, to ensure equal stands and opportunities to the women, and to ensure equal rights of male and female children to live and develop. How I can say you that, dear students, please try to understand all these nitty-gritty, please try to understand all these points, so that you can specify social equality, what are the social equality and how does it bring a kinds of social development for all sections of the society. That is the point that you have to know. Okay, right. Okay, now civil equality. Civil equality is also a topic. It is elaborated as the grant of equal rights and the freedoms to all the people and social groups. All the people are to be treated upon before law. Civil liberty comprises of the enjoyment of similar civil liberty and civil rights by all the citizens. Civil laws should treat all the individuals equally. I mean to say that there must be a civil equality. Any person should not be ill-treated. All the civil rights should be given to the persons. This is what you have to also understand. There should be not be any discriminations of superior and inferior, the rich and the poor, caste and creed, color and race, kaum and tribes, groups and classes. Rule of law is in force in England, and in the eyes of the rule of law, all are equal. Equal treatment is given to all by the rule of law. This is what in our country it is also there, and it is also the political science theory that you have to also understand. What does it exactly mean? That it means that the equal rights and the freedoms must be given to the all people and social group. All the people are treated equal before law, irrespective of their class, creed and caste. All the civil liberty comprises and similar civil liberties and civil rights should be given to the citizens. Civil laws should treat all the individual equally. There should not be any kinds of discrimination the superiority or inferiority, the rich and the poor, I mean in the name of any group, should not be there. Rule of law is in the force in England. So before the eyes of the rule of law, all are equal, and all equal treatment is given to all by the rule of law. This is what you have to understand. So I can make you sure that everything is possible and anything is possible when all things you understand in a very perfect manner, because political science is a subject where you have to see in and around, and you have to also relate with our political system. Because the political system is a classical example of all our things and all. If you understand this integrity, then definitely it will help you. Please try to understand these things. Political science is a topic where you can understand these things, and I hope that if you can understand, then you can understand civil equality also. Next, you know the political equality. Also very important point, political equality. It is referred as the equal opportunities for the participations of all in the political processes. This involves the concept of grant of equal political rights for all citizens with some uniform qualifications for everyone. All citizens must possess similar political rights. They should have similar voice in the working of the government, and they should have equal opportunities to actively participate in the political life and affairs of the country. Political equality guarantees the enjoyment of similar political rights to all its citizens. Universal adult franchise is a means to this ends. Universal adult suffrage has been introduced in India. The same provision has been made in England, USSR, USA, France, and many more other countries. So the political equality means that anyone can go for any political party, go for any political ideology. Anyone can fight the election, contest the election, having the minimum fair qualifications which is required to be eligible. These all things are possible, and definitely universal adult suffrage had given, you know, like in other countries, like in USA, like in England, like in USSR or France and many other countries. These are the things that you have to also understand. So I think political equality, such an important equality which gives a lot of opportunities for the all section of the society to prove themselves, get themselves, and to fight themselves for the justice, all kinds of justice, all kinds of rights. And I can assure you that through political economy, the developing nations, particularly if you talk in India, a lot of things have changed, a lot of, you know, powers have been changed. This is what you have to also understand. And everything is possible when you understand these things. Okay, this is what you have to understand. Now, after this political equality, what else you have to study? Yes, next, economic equality. Economic equality is also very important, because without economic equality, this, you know, nothing can be achievable. So that is what you have to also understand. And what is, you know, the economic equality? Economic equality does not indicate that, you know, equal treatment of equal reward or the equal wages for all. It denotes fair and adequate opportunities to all for work and for earning of their livelihoods. It also means that primary needs of all should be fulfilled before the special needs of few are gratified. The gap between rich and poor should be lowest. There should be equitable distribution of the wealth and resources in the society. This is what you have to also understand, that the economic equality is something that it does not guarantee equal treatment or equal reward or equal wages for all. It has to be denoted adequate opportunities to all for work, for the earning of their livelihood. It also means that the primary needs of all should be fulfilled before their special needs. Economic equality is closely associated to the political equality also. Professor Lasky stated the immense significance of economic equality. Political equality is never real unless it is accompanied with the virtual economic liberty, political power. It is the Lasky's statement. Suppose you know, it is very true that without the economic prosperity, without the economic liberty, without the economic upliftment, any other upliftment cannot have that much of significance, because without money, nothing can happen. And if any country, any individual is not that much having the economic power, then definitely he or any society cannot survive. This is very important. So we have to also take care of Professor Lasky's view, right? Okay. So if you understand all these things, it will definitely help you in the understanding of all. Okay. Please try to understand all these points. Next, according to Lord Bryce, economic equality is the attempt to expunge all differences in the wealth allotting to every man and woman, an equal share in worldly goods. But this concept of perfect economic equality can never be materialized in the practical politics. Generally, economic equality means the provision of equal opportunities to all, so they may be able to make their economic progress. This can be done only in socialism and not in capitalism. Henceforth, capitalism should be replaced by socialism. This is what these are the different kinds of narratives that you can have. You can understand all these things, but primarily you have to understand all these nitty-gritty points, all these points, so that you can have a better understanding. Okay, please try to understand all these things so that you can make all these points in a perfect manner. Next, you know the legal equality. What does it mean, the legal equality? Because you know legal equality is also very important. Legal equality is defined as equality before law, equal subjections of the law to the same legal code and legal opportunities, all to secure legal protection of their rights and freedom. There should, you know, rule and law must be equally binding for all. In every society, equality must be ensured in all these forms. Legal equality means that everyone is equal before the law, and if any crime or anything is happened, the people from the different strata must be treated equally. Because before the law, everyone is equal. Anyone cannot be deprived of the legal help. Anyone cannot be deprived of the legal help, because it is very simple that everything is there and anything is out there. But it should be seen that the law can be equal for all. This is what the legal equality. Next, you know, after the legal equality, you have to understand the equality of opportunity and education. What is the equality of opportunity and education? It is also very important, because without it, nothing can be possible. Equality of opportunity and education means that all citizens should be given equal and similar opportunities by the state. All the individuals should have similar chances to receive education. They should have similar opportunity to develop their personality. Racial or any type of discrimination should not be observed. There should not be any distinction of the caste and creed, color and race, rich and poor. In India, all are provided with equal opportunities and all have equal rights to education. That is why right to education has given in our constitution. So this is a very important point, that the equal opportunities and equal education should be given, so that any person should not be deprived, and they should develop themselves through their personality. So this is what it means, what that the equal opportunities should be given, or particularly opportunities and the education also. Without education, particularly, you know, in the field of education, without education, nothing can happen. So, it is the duty and it is the onus and responsibility of the state to provide the equal opportunities to the people of this country so that they can have a better understanding, so that they can develop themselves, and on that basis only, you know, everything is possible for themselves. Okay, now you know relationship between equality and freedom. So if the relationship between equality and freedom, it is also very important to know. So what is the relation between equality and freedom? That we have to know. First of all, the concepts and freedom and equality in a group are defined in terms of individual exertions of influence or power. Freedom is, you know, deliberated in the version freedom from influence rather than the version freedom to do what wants. It is revealed that at the ideal conceptual level, complete freedom implies equality. The relationship between freedom and equality is a complex, as it is something people have struggled for since the beginning of time and to continue to struggle for today. These two terms are strongly linked, though not inseparable. This is what you have to also understand, that how between the equality and freedom, it is the duty of the state to provide the freedom to the people of this country. It is the duty of the state to provide the equal opportunity to its people, and that is the state duty. It has to be also understood that everything can be achievable when the state gives opportunity to its citizen. And I think that if you do all sort of things, only then you can understand in a perfect and rightful manner. Next, you know, equality has simple meaning. What is the meaning? It is resemblance or the sameness in quality, power, status or degree. It also simpler terms, it is being the exact same as others. Freedom is the condition of being able to act and think however you want without being controlled or limited. The relationship between these two first begins by obtaining freedom. Without freedom, one does not have the ability to be equal to others. You know, opinion that man cannot become absolutely equal unless they are entirely free. One who is not free has a master who makes his choices for him. This is what Tocqueville has said. These are also quotation in the political science that you should also remember, because I feel that if you remember all these quotations, it will definitely help you. Okay, now you know the only way rid himself of the master and gain political freedom is to successfully revolt against the state. With this uprising, all people now have the ability to act however they want, and because of this, they are considered equal. Once they are free from their human masters, they are able to lead a life directed by their own free will and compete on a level playing field with the rest of society. If you understand all these things, you will have a great understanding. Next, the development of freedom and equality being with the Declaration of Independence, which set the precedents, all men are created equal. Up until this point, equality was something that could not be attained. It was almost a foreign idea, although only white men in America were considered free after this great document was signed. The Declaration of Independence paved the way for many new forms of equality, most importantly, gender and racial equality. Nowadays, if you look at that, the people are talking about the gender equality. A lot of other equalities have been achieved, so they are talking about gender equality and the racial equality. This is also very important. Affirmative actions. What are the affirmative actions? Affirmative actions is the strategy to end members of a disadvantaged group who currently suffer or historically have suffered from the discrimination within a culture. Often these people are deprived for historical reasons such as oppressions or bondages. The notion of affirmative action was first used in the United States in the executive order number this signed by President John F. Kennedy on March 6, 1961, which included a provision that the government contractors take affirmative actions to ensure that applicants are employed and employees are treated during employment without regard to their race, creed, color, and national origin. So these are the things that you have to also understand in a very proper way. In 1967, gender was added to the anti-discrimination list. In 1989, the International Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Racial Discrimination, in Article 2.2, that also affirmative action programs may be required of the countries that ratified the convention in order to rectify systematic discrimination. It also states that, you know, such programs shall in no case entails as a consequence in the maintenance of unequal or separate rights for the different racial groups after the objectives for which they were taken have been achieved. So I think if you understand all these things, then your understanding on equality, freedom would be much better. Next, you know, in simple term, affirmative action is anticipated to promote the opportunities of defended minority groups within a society to give them equal access to that of the majority population. In India, reservation in India is a form of affirmative action designed to improve the well-being of backward and underrepresented communities defined primarily by their caste. So, affirmative action means when suppose our government has given a reservation policy just to uplift them. This is also a kind of affirmative action that you can understand. Affirmative actions are there that you have to understand. All these things are there historically, internationally. These all things you can understand, or it could be indirect or direct. These are the feature of affirmative actions that you have to understand. Next, about the USA, that how USA affirmative action is an active effort to increase employment or educational opportunities for the members of minority groups, even for women also. So these are the things about even, you know, in United States of America, affirmative actions in Indian scenario, notion of affirmative actions, it is also very important, and the discriminations are there. So all these things should be stopped. And I think have to understand all these things in a very perfect manner. And how the articles 341 and 342 included list of caste tribes, these are also very important. Consequences of affirmative actions in India, this is also very important. The reverse discrimination, the system of affirmative action, the majority of populace feel omitted and discriminated against as the allocation of jobs. And that, you know, in India, the government continues to reinforce reservations and increases the quotas to gain vote banks, and the majority feel acutely sidelined. The system of reservation was meant to last for a decade or so, but it has to become so established in the contemporary times that the majority are naturally in disdain of it. So what does it mean? That it is also the duty of the government to provide solace to the people of the society so that any discontent would not be there, and they should also obey the government's norms. Next, the heated issues of Patidar reservation agitation in India is best example of reverse discrimination in India. Patels, you know, as a prosperous caste in India, are also highlighting themselves as backward classes. Being so, they demand reservations in jobs and in the educational institutions. The same way the disadvantaged OBCs are entitled to do. What happened with the considerable quotas put aside for the marginalized? The majority has to bear the burden of tightened and hence highly competitive vacancies and posts, resulting in many meritorious candidates losing at academic and career opportunities. The Patels who belong to a commercial community fear the loss of their jobs or unavailability of jobs altogether. It speaks volumes on reverse discrimination in India. This is what we have to also understand, that what happened in the Gujarat, how recently, you know, the Patels had given the agitations. They demanded jobs, reservation, and everything when the full college institution reservation. But it was not unlike as backwards have been given the reservation, because Patels had a very prosperous community and they had a very good background. Okay, but it is a kind of reverse discrimination that you have to also understand. Brain drain, it is also very important to know. What is brain drain? Brain drain means it is major outcome of identity based politics in India. Due to reservations and quota based system, the public feels challenged, destabilized, and even rejected as a selections in jobs and education are made on the criterion of caste and merit. Hence, the intellectuals are forced to work abroad, and the phenomenon of brain drain keeps draining India of its think tanks and learned scholars and intellectuals. So what does it happen that if it is a kind of something like that, then definitely people of India are going outside of the country, and think tanks are going, scholars are going, intellectuals are going. This is the brain drain that you have to also understand. So what I feel that if you understand all these things, definitely you would be better positions to understand. And I hope that in the political science what happens, that everything you have to look at your perspective. This is the beauty of political science. The theories are there. Definitely, like the great thinkers and like great philosophers, what they have said, that really matters a lot, undoubtedly. But at the same time, you have to also look at the perspective of the contemporary social issues. Like just now, we have discussed about the reverse reservation policy and also reverse reaction, and also about the Gujarat problems, how the Patels had when the agitation. I feel that if you understand all these things, then you can write a better answer. Because it is the demand of UPSC that any student who is writing an answer, he should have a better understanding of the topic, and he should also incorporate, he should also relate the present discussions, the present contemporary issues, so that the answer should be very perfect. So what I suggest to you, that before writing an answer, as I have done in most of the videos that I have given, lots of GS series also, that in which I have given the moral answer. The moral answer is something all about that you have to make answer format, because first of all you have to write introduction, then description, and then conclusion. But what exactly you have to write in the introduction, that is also a matter of discussion. Because if you don't know what exact point you are going to write, your answer is not going to be perfect. It is not the test of the knowledge. Undoubtedly it is the test, but in that context, while you are writing an answer, you may have a good knowledge on that particular topic. But when it comes for the description of writing the words, keywords, key portions of the questions have been asked, then according to that question only you have to reply. And if you cannot reply in a perfect and rightful manner, then you are definitely not going to fetch good marks. These are the points that you have to always keep in mind. What I mean to say, that before winding up, I have to make you understand that all these topics, whether it is equality and any other topics that are very enjoyable topics, you can also find out in and around society. But most important thing, that writing must be kept always, so that writing, through writing, what happens, that you can remember all of points, all of things. Like today, if you revise your pages, then you can say that what are the consequences and actions, the reverse description, article 341-42. Also we had affirmative actions in India, USO, and then we had a lot of discussions 1967, what happened, and affirmative actions then, and how the equality opportunities and the education, legal equality we talked of. Besides, we had also talked of economic equality, it was very important. Political equality, also civil equality was also very important. And besides civil equality, you have to have social equality. Social equality is also very important. And equality has three basic elements that I had discussed. And before that, characteristics of equality, we had discussed that, how characteristics of equality is important. And besides, also suppose we had discussed about the equalities things and many dimensions of the equality. These are the things that I have discussed with all together. Precisely, I have to say all of you that please try to understand that the topics that you are going to discuss, which are the main keywords, which thinkers, which thoughts are very important, because it is it is UPSC preparation. You should have your syllabus before you, and accordingly you have to take care of all sort of things, so that you would have a better understanding, better kinds of things. And most of the time what happens that and don't follow this protocol, so definitely it really hampers your preparation. You should have that kinds of things and all, and I hope that it will definitely have a better understanding, better kinds of things, right? Okay, now I have to make you understand that by understanding these all things, you will have better positions, demanding positions, and write, at least you write one and two time, then see the question paper, read all these things in a very nitty-gritty way, then definitely you would have the command on all these topics. Because I hope that if anyone does the practice in this way, nothing can stop you, nothing can forbid you, it is you only to understand the things. Because as an educator, I can give you a good piece of suggestions, good piece of things, so that you can understand all kinds of things. So this is what from my side, and once again thank you very much for watching my video, and I hope that you love this class, and in the next class I will be also discussing the concepts of human rights. All these things are very important, okay, very important, okay dear students, right? So my code is RJ01. If you apply RJ01, you can have 10% discounts on all the topics. So my Telegram link is Discourse Academy Rakesh Jha. Okay, please stay safe, be safe. Once again, thank you very much. Take care. Bye bye. And if any query is out there, you can discuss with me through my Telegram link. Once again, thank you very much.